finally tonight, famed musician Graham Nash has just come out with a new memoir of his life in rock and roll. Titled Wild Tales, in the mid-1960s, Nash had numerous number one pop hits with the British band The Hollies. He later became part of the supergroup Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. Jeffrey Brown talked with him recently while on a new solo tour at the Birchmere in Alexandria, Virginia. Here's an excerpt of their conversation where Nash talked about some of his famous musical and life partners.
So let me just say some names at you and give me your impression. Stephen Stills.
Certainly one of the finest guitar players in the world. Certainly, to certain I think he's a very underrated guitar player. You know, I read the top 50 guitar players in Rolling Stone, and he's somewhere around the bottom, and that's just not right. I mean, he's an incredible guitar player.
David Crosby.
Crosby is one of the most unique musicians I know. When I was doing his box set, and I did Stevens, and I did mine, of course, I began to realize just how unique Crosby was. You know, his sense of jazz, you know, which is one of his first loves, is pervades all his music, and it's very different than Graham Nash music, and it shouldn't work, but it really works like a band-aid.
Neil Young
is probably one of the strangest of my friends. He is adamant about following his heart. He is serious as a heart attack about his music. He brings a darker edge. I don't mean darker in a negative sense, but it more of an intensity to our music. You know, the music of Crosby, Stills, and Nash that was born in the summer of love was lighter, sunnier. Neil's, you know, the sun turns down a little when Neil comes into the band.
And Joni Mitchell.
Joni is, in my opinion, a genius. She is an outstanding woman. Obviously very beautiful, but incredibly talented when it comes to songwriting. She's really painting with words.
And what about Graham Nash? What did you bring to all this?
Wow.
I stumped you finally.
Yeah, what did Graham Nash bring to this madness? Maybe a little stability. I'd been through it all with the Hollies. I'd been through all the screaming girls. I'd been through all the crowds where you couldn't hear yourself play because of the noise they were making. I'd been through having my clothes torn. I'd been through all that, so it was no big deal to me. I mean, I wasn't even nervous at Woodstock. It was Stephen that said that we were scared, you know.
You can say it. but you know, you
talk about the girls and people ripping your clothes. There's a lot of sex, drugs, and rock and roll in this book.
But it's not only that.
No.
It's about love and friendship and loyalty and being there for your friends when they're obviously hurting. That was one of my main concerns with this book, was how David Crosby would react to it. Because I was brutally honest about it.
Chronicling all his problems.
Yeah, about what was going on with him and how it affected me personally. Mm-hmm. So when I called David and talked to him, he said, no, I did all that. I did put you guys through all that. I did spiral down. Every word is true. Don't change a word. And it gave me a great sense of relief.
You can watch Jeff's full conversation with Graham Nash on the Artbeat page on our website.